Hi, I'm James Kelly, a product manager on the Android team, and I'm here to talk about Android Work. Android Work is a complete solution to make Android awesome at work for employees and businesses. So let's start with apps. Android Work has a unified interaction model across both personal and enterprise apps, which will make it easier for employees to have a single device for personal use and work. IT administrators will be able to make apps from Google Play available to users and groups within their organization. We've enhanced the Android framework so that Android for Work devices offer a unified view of notifications and recents in a single launcher across both personal and work apps. In the launcher, apps will be badged with the Android Work logo to indicate that the app and its data are separately and securely administered by IT. Android Work adds new features to support organizations that allow Bring Your Own Device, or BYOD, and companies that issue corporate-owned devices to employees. In BYOD, employees use their Android device for work. To enable this, an IT administrator can create a secure work profile on the device to separate apps and data required for work from personal apps and data. We've made enhancements to unify both personal and work apps within the launcher and to make notifications and recents appear from either profile. This creates a unified user experience but preserves appropriate separation to enable a secure environment for business data. For company-owned devices, IT administrators can start with a new device, and through a simple provisioning step, the enterprise is configured as the device's owner. A device owner is a special type of device admin that cannot be deactivated. The company then has full control of the entire device, including data and apps. The Android Work device owner model is designed specifically to meet the highest requirements for remote administration and security, and builds on existing Android concepts of device administrator. For this release, we've added new APIs to accompany the unified user experience, support Android Work profiles, and more. A set of capabilities for policy and app management will be common across all Android Work devices. Let's start with Manage User APIs. As part of activating a device for BYOD, a device policy client app creates an Android Work profile to separate company apps and data from the personal space. The Android Work profile is created only after an employee supplies a set of credentials to their DPC approved by the IT admin. A work profile is owned by the DPC, but is associated with the primary user in such a way that notifications and the recents list are shared. Now moving on to profile owner APIs. A profile owner is a special case of a device administrator that has additional capabilities. As well as having access to a number of additional APIs, the profile owner cannot be modified by the primary user. Profile owners are scoped to the Android Work profile and can only be defined as part of the Android Work provisioning process approved by the IT admin. Next, device owner. A device owner is like a profile owner, but scoped to the whole device. Device owner is an additional level of privilege that's a superset of profile owner privileges. Starting only from an unprovisioned state, a device owner can affect the whole device, including, for example, Wi-Fi access. All profile owner APIs are accessible to device owners. Android Work APIs will primarily be used by mobile device management developers. Other types of apps don't need to designate themselves as profile or device owner. And that's an important point. To most app developers, Android Work will be transparent. So going forward from this Android release, you can focus simply on addressing enterprise needs. Now, let's turn to Google Play. Android Work introduces new ways to support large-scale app deployment within an enterprise via Play for the Android Work profile. An IT admin can select which apps from the Play Store are available for their employees. This works whether a company uses just a few apps or hundreds. Google Play will offer enterprises new options for licensing, including bulk purchase. So apps can be purchased and deployed across organizations in a single, easy transaction. As we touched on before, enterprises normally partner with specialist mobility management companies to manage their mixed fleets of corporate-owned and employee-owned devices. And so new APIs on Google Play allow enterprise mobility management or EMM providers to integrate Android device management into their existing products or to offer value-added features. Registered EMM providers can offer secure authentication to enterprise servers, control access to enterprise apps, and can set policies to restrict what the user can do within the work profile. On the device itself, Google Play will securely provision apps within the Android work profile. The IT admin has fine-grained controls to make apps from Google Play available to individual employees, groups, or to the whole company. IT admins can even deploy their own internally hosted apps direct to the work profile via the Play Store app. Finally, enterprise applications sometimes have some functionality which is intended to be configured by the IT admin rather than the end user. And so we've added APIs for configuring per application policies. EMMs can configure per app policies using the device policy client via a new method in Device Policy Manager in the Android framework. I hope this was a useful introduction to Android work. We are really excited to work with our device partners, app developers, and business to help bring the power of Android to the office. For now, we have a device admin code sample and API documentation available in the L developer preview. And later this year, we'll have updates for you as the first Android work devices are announced. It's been a real privilege to introduce you to new ways to securely work and play on the devices you love. And now it's over to you, so that together we can make Android work for work. My name is James Kelly, and thanks for watching.